Bitcoin surprise! Hey guys, what's happening there? How are you doing today? Welcome back to the Crypto Bliss Show. I'm Kiara DeCasse and I will be hosting an incredibly powerful show for you today. I've got lots of content to show you in this video today, so make sure to stay tuned for the entire video because you're not going to want to miss out on this. I have plenty of content from various sources that are going to show you that you absolutely need to get one Bitcoin or at least 0.01 Bitcoin right now. Okay, let's go out and see what we can do in this video, guys. I made some crazy videos for you over the past few days, so go and enjoy those. Thanks for being here with me on the Crypto Bliss Show. And if you guys want to trade cryptocurrency with me, make sure to hit the pinned comment down below. It'll be your BitFlex link to your beautiful lifestyle trading, and you guys can go ahead and trade all these beautiful cryptocurrencies with me. So I'm going to fly through the usual stuff today. Nearly $1.1 trillion again, $35 billion in trading volume. Bitcoin is slowly creeping up ever so slowly, and so is Ethereum. I mean, Ethereum is about $10, $12 higher than it was yesterday from my time of doing that video for you. So very, very interesting. I'm going to close that up for now. Fear and Greed Index, the same as yesterday, sitting at 45. And then lastly, the crypto bubbles, of course, guys. Crypto bubbles, pretty much even Stevens. We got some of them pumping today. Ape and CFX are down. So most of it is in the slight green. VeChain pumping, which is a good one. You guys want to know that VeChain and Zilliqa and those two projects, Immutable X, are going to be some of the craziest projects to get into. Filecoin as well. No financial advice, guys. I'm just showing you what I'm doing. I have accumulated quite a good substantial amount of crypto so far already, and I would like to know if my community also has a good amount of crypto. Let me know down in the comments below, how many cryptocurrencies are you holding? I would love to know. Let me know down below, please, guys. All right, so let's not waste any time, guys. I want to jump onto the Dixie chart very, very quickly. Bearing in mind that you can see that we've been running. We made some sort of pump up here yesterday. So my bear flag was invalidated. My bear flag pattern was invalidated, but we're now above this green zone. But we're still below this area right here, right now. So that is still a lower high. So let's go and see what happens today over the course of the week. The total cryptocurrency market cap is making its way back up to this area here with good buy volume, strong RSI action coming in here. Let us go and quickly have a look at what this is doing on the weeklies. Ooh, on the weekly, we're actually looking juicy. We're looking as though we would like to make a pump up here, probably back up to this 50 moving average, which is very, very interesting. Then the last thing I want to go and show you is the US, the last chart before I carry on with some of the news is the USDT. Guys, we got a double top busy happening over here on the daily time frame. So this is perhaps a little bit of a moment to say, okay, well, we've double topped. You know, there is some sort of M pattern that is kind of forming. This will be the neckline to basically break. If we break that neckline, we're coming back down to this purple box here without a doubt, guys. So that is the USDT. Let's just pull this line across for us. That is the USDT market cap dominance. And then, guys, just in coordination, I want to show you the S&P very, very quickly, okay? Because I'm going to be talking about recessions in this video. So you can see here the S&P made a decent rally up there on the RSI, which is not much momentum. We slowed down this momentum here by meeting that level of resistance. So, guys, in the meantime, there is a potential that we are going to be making lower high, consecutive lower highs here, unless we actually break through this and kind of retest and then carry on the momentum to the upside. What do you guys think is going to happen here with the S&P? Let me know down in the comments below. Do you think we will be rejected or do you think we are about to pump? Now, the RSI says something different, right? And then on the weekly, on top of it, we are at the bottom. So this is looking healthy on the higher time frames, and the higher time frames are, of course, the better time frames the macro time frames are the better ones to look, watch out for. Now, guys, I want to show you crazy videos that I have been, it took me a long time to go through this and research this. So I'm going to share some good news with you guys, and I'm going to share some bad news with you guys. I'm going to start off with the bad news, and then I'm going to end off on the good news, so that we end off on good energy and good hype. So let's jump right into this video right here. I'm just going to show you about a minute and a half of this. This is Mr. Atheology, Astrotheology. This is Santos Bonacci. My brother follows him, has been following him for a number of years, and he's learned tremendous amounts. And this is why my brother is an incredible astrologist. And Mr. Santos Bonacci is an incredibly powerful astrologist, and he travels across the world speaking truth and revealing truth and information against all kinds of stuff and following astrology, because billionaires use astrologers to learn exactly what to do at which times to do them. And in this video that I'm about to show you, you will see the content that follows this video, exactly what is potentially about to happen the latter ends of September towards the end of October. Guys, this is Santos Bonacci.
It's not necessary. We can take that out. There you've got the eight-spoke wheel, the famous eight-spoke wheel. And at all these points, friends, all of these points, mass shootings, psyops, they're all based on those 8 days, okay? Now, this one is all about judgment, justice. Justice is coming. Something financial is going to happen. Remember, all stock market, the three biggest stock market crashes, 1929, happened on October the 19th, just here in Libra, at the end of Libra, right here. Libra, stock market crash, the worst depression in history, 1929, the 19th of October. Okay, I'm not fear-mongering here, guys.
19 October.
I'm just pointing out how things work. This is how things work. That's all you need. This is just sharing knowledge, okay? I don't want anybody to be afraid. I don't want anybody thinking that I'm, you know, predicting anything. I'm letting astrology talk here, and I'm letting the wheel of nature, God's will, which is this one, the cycles of nature, to speak to you, okay? Now, the other two, 1988 and 20 years later, 2008, they happen on the 25th of October. So you got the 19th of October and the 25th. Two stock market crashes happened here, and the one in 1929 happened here. The worst stock market crashes. Admittedly, that's Scorpio territory. That is not Libra. But Scorpio is the number 8. It's about destruction. So what it's telling you is that Judgment Day comes here. Everyone thinks the 15th of March So that's March the 21st. Now, the 15th of April, isn't it? Anyway, everyone believes that, knows about tax day over here, right? But this is economy, finance time. This is the month of finance. As I said, everything happened, all the three worst stock market crashes in history happened between the 19th and the 25th. This is Libra, this is Scorpio. This is finance and justice and judgment. This is destruction and transformation.
Okay, so with destruction and transformation, what do you believe is going to happen when you have all three of the world's biggest recessions we have ever seen happen within a 6-day time frame period on the same time frame period over and over again? Well, let's go and have a proper look at that so that you can get a visual perspective of this. So this is from Investopedia, a very reliable source, and this is the contemporary US stock market crashes. So you can see all the way from 1929 up to 2020. Now you can see here, 1929 You can see here at the end of the market on day 4th, 2020, what is known as Black Thursday, that dropped a 21% decline. A selling panic began on October 28th. So that was like 4 days difference. So that was probably on the Friday and the Monday, somewhere along that. Now, you can see here that year on year on year, over and over and over. Here's Black Monday, 1987. What he was talking about is the October 1987. I mean, it's the same year I was born. And then here, Friday the 13th, October 13th, 1989. And then the 90s recession, and then the dot-com bubble. Let's go and have a look at the rest of here. So the September, the 2008 recession happened on September 29th. Ironically, it happened, and didn't 9/11 happen in September as well, on the 11th of September? Okay, so September and October seem to be the months of destruction. So you guys can see here, so there was a flash crash there. Let's see here, that was March 16th. Let's go see here. Notable downturns. Okay, so you can see there that that's what happened there. Okay, so now that I've shown you that news, that we can see that there are three specific timelines that we have seen over the time. So 1929, 2008, and 1987 over here. So these two, basically, 1987 and 1989. So they both, they all four basically happened around the similar timing pattern. Now, that is very, very interesting, because with Bitcoin being around, Bitcoin is a hedge against inflation. It is a hedge against economic destruction. And Bitcoin is the king of value of storage. It is the king of assets. It is better than gold. It is better than silver. It is better than property. Property returns an average of 4% annual returns a year. So if you invested $1 million, you were getting 4% a year. That's $40,000 that you were getting per year. But if you took the same liquidity, okay, and invested it into Bitcoin, your Bitcoin average returns per year would be 80%, okay? Which means on your $1 million, you would have made $800,000 profit. Can you see the difference? And that's on property, the world's best, supposedly the world's best passive income and profit accumulation asset. Well, guys, I'm sorry to say that, but Bitcoin is the king. That's why Bitcoin is crowned as the king. That's why I always refer to it as the king. Regardless of whether we have a smash down, it doesn't matter, because you just, over the long term, it has 80% returns a year on average, guys. Come on, you need to know this right now. So if you're owning 0.1 or 0.01 Bitcoin, in the future, you have a chance of becoming a millionaire. Imagine, in America, there's something like 55 million millionaires in America alone, let alone the rest of the world. There's only 21 million Bitcoin, and about 17 million of those Bitcoin have already been scooped up by long-term holders. Guys, there's plus minus like 4 million Bitcoin left. Now, could you imagine when the BlackRock and all of the ETFs are approved, what is going to happen? That Bitcoin is going to be scooped up faster than you can know. And they are going to sell that Bitcoin back to you for profits for their pockets, okay? And they're going to sell it back to you at the highest prices. Do not miss out on the opportunity to trade Bitcoin today. Invest today. No financial advice. Use my links down below, because you are going to build yourself and you're going to secure your family's wealth into the future. This will be generational wealth that you will develop. And think about it. Property versus Bitcoin. Property will never ever catch up to Bitcoin, because Bitcoin on average is giving you 80% returns. It's 20x more than property, guys. So are you going to invest in property, especially while interest rates are high? You also have to look after the property, maintain it, spend money on it, spend time on it, all kinds of crazy things. Whereas Bitcoin, all you're doing is taking your hard-earned sweat equity, your cash, or your dry powder, your white powder, and popping it into Bitcoin and leaving it in a cold storage wallet, guys. Cold storage wallet. Let me show you very, very quickly. Yeah. Yeah. So, cold storage wallet. Boom. Ledger Nano X, guys. This is what you want to have. This is called a cold storage wallet. This is what you want to have to actually store your cryptocurrency away from the institutions, away from the regulatory system, away from the banking systems, because that will protect your crypto, and that is a bank in your own pocket. You are your own bank. Okay, now let's get on to some of the very, very cool news here, guys. Before I do that, I want to go and show you the Bitcoin chart. Let's go show you this one on a monthly basis, okay? Because on a monthly basis, look at it. It has only ever gone up. What do you think it's still going to do, guys? It's still only going to go up for a very, very long time, okay? No financial advice. You guys are enjoying the content. Please smash a thumbs up on the video and share this content with your friends, because you know that it helps the YouTube spread this message and this algorithm for all of us. So I want to show you a video by David Marcus. And sure, this is incredible. So David Marcus is the former PayPal president. So let's go and listen to this video quickly.
It's important for the world to have an open, interoperable, cheap payment protocol for the internet. And we believe Lightning is that, and I believe Lightning is the only network that will actually be able to do that. And so I want to dedicate the rest of my life to actually making it happen, because the world needs it. It's important.
How incredible is that? He is literally going to dedicate the rest of his life to making Bitcoin an interoperable payment system that the world can use as a facilitating currency. Wow. That's incredible. Guys, from BRICS trying to de-dollarize, Bitcoin is 100% going to, it already is de-dollarized, okay, from that perspective. So, guys, I don't know what, but if I haven't already convinced you that Bitcoin is going to be the hedge against all of the problems that the world sees, then I don't know what else. You guys need to probably look at some of your own research. This is from Squawkbox. Crypto is settling as part of the ecosystem. So listen to this video here from Mohammed Al-Irian. Excuse that pronouncement.
I was going to move on to crypto, if you'd indulge me for a second, because we always have these crypto conversations. And there seems to be this thing happening. I don't know, Joe, we were talking about $25,000 with Bitcoin. Meanwhile, BlackRock and all these folks, all the folks that we thought were never going to do this, are now doing it, and yet it's not moving at all.
Well, it's moving today.
Well, I mean, sure, 26. This is 26.
It was 4 when we started saying it wasn't going anywhere. 4,000.
Oh, well, okay. But the question is this now a risk on, a risk off thing? How do you even correlate this to what's happening with the Fed? Because for a long time, you used to talk about crypto in regard to the Fed.
So I think crypto settling as part of the ecosystem, I think people have recognized it is not the new global currency. People have also recognized it's not going to disappear tomorrow. It's becoming institutionalized. And I think, actually, if I were a crypto person, I think this maturation process is a good thing. Where it moves from day to day, I can't really comment on that.
I still think it's outperforming every asset, 1 year, 5 year, and 10 year.
Okay,
it still outperformed every single asset. 1 year, 5 year, 10 year. Guys, I know that you are getting so excited about what I'm showing you. So here's another video from the former president of PayPal, which is David Marcus once again, and he's going to be talking about building on Bitcoin. And essentially, let's just close this Telegram, yeah. He's going to be talking about building on Bitcoin. Let's go and listen to this quick short video.
In the state of fintech and the state of payments and where we really are, you're working on a new project. I shouldn't even say a new project, but a project around the Lightning Network, which is aimed at basically taking Bitcoin. You can explain it better than I can. Effectively, you take it off chain and then put it back on chain to make these transactions faster.
Yes, actually, what we're trying to do is turn Bitcoin into a real payment, global payment network, because
You know, we have many tourists walking right outside of the studio right now. If you were to stop one of them and wanting to communicate with them, you could ask them for an email address and you can email them easily the next minute. You could text them, you could add them to a group video chat, you can do all of these things. But if you were to send them money, if they were not a U.S. citizen here in the U.S. using one of the same fintech apps you're using, then you wouldn't be able to do that. And so we're still in the fax era of global payments, and that's what we're attempting to solve.
Right. Well, why is that so important, by the way? Because the truth is, I can use Venmo. I mean, others can use services that are connected to each other. Why is that such a terrible answer?
So let's double click on that for a second. So you can use Venmo, but if someone is not using Venmo or is an international tourist walking right outside
an iPhone and I want to message somebody, I mean, if I don't have WhatsApp and somebody wants to WhatsApp me, they have to get the WhatsApp app.
But you have text, which is universal, where you can actually communicate and reach out to anyone you want in the world with one simple addressing scheme, which is a phone number, which is human readable. And you can't do that with money. There's no universal protocol for money on the internet that actually enables value to be transported through the internet. So if you were to want to send money to one of these people, you would probably need to ask them for a bank account number. The bank account number would be in different format depending on where you are in the world. You would have to actually physically walk to a branch and pay $50 to do an international wire. And if it's after Friday, 5 p.m., tough luck.
And how big a business is that?
It's ginormous, right? It's trillions of dollars of transactions that transit through SWIFT and other payment networks.
Well, let me ask you a separate question, which is around Bitcoin. We've watched the valuation of Bitcoin sort of sit around $25,000, $26,000. We've all been questioning, so where does this go? And does Bitcoin ever really become a currency, which is what you talk about it becoming? Do you think the value of Bitcoin needs to or can move up if it's actually currency? Meaning, I've always made the argument the currency problem is if you think Bitcoin is going to $30,000 or $50,000 or $60,000, there's no way I'm going to spend it on a pizza or on anything, frankly. Mm-hmm. If I think it's going to go down, by the way, I might spend it immediately.
Our view is actually that Bitcoin is not the currency that people will use to buy things, but a fragment of a Bitcoin on top of Lightning is like a small packet, data packet on the internet, only for value. And so you can exchange at the edges of the network and send dollars to someone that will receive Japanese yen on the other side, or send dollars to someone who will receive euros on the other side. And the actual net settlement layer that is used is basically Bitcoin, Lightning, and it settles in real time, cash final, and at a very, very low cost.
How absolutely phenomenally incredible, right? So if I have not yet convinced you yet, hopefully these guys can convince you that Bitcoin is going to be a huge store of value. It is a hedge against inflation. It is a hedge against all currency printing that is currently happening right now. And we'll touch base on currency printing in a little moment. But before I do that, I just want to go back to a chart where I showed you the U.S. The U.S. recession. So you guys can see here, 1968, recession, 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 recession. Look how long they last for, more or less kind of a couple months each. So right now you can see we're flatlining and we're not there yet. But if you look at this and you look at this from the macro perspective that it is, guys, we already have this at a low end, right? And we know when the RSI is oversold, it's time for it to shoot up. What happens when it shoots up? Okay, look at this. This didn't even shoot up here. I mean, this shot up over here and nothing happened on this line. So that is very interesting. So it must have happened in a very short space of time, but boom, crazy recession that happened there. Okay, so now coming on to the next. So I've shown you David Marcus. I've shown you this. Let us go and have a look at a couple other things. So Shapeshift is taking crypto interoperability to the highest level. It is now possible to natively store and exchange Bitcoin, Atom, and Dodge on the MetaMask wallet. Hallelujah! So what happened? The summary of it, Shapeshift and the integration with MetaMask wallet, maximum crypto interoperability and interoperability between multiple blockchains is a trend to grow. Well done to Shapeshift for doing that. Incredible, incredible feat. So in wonderful energy there by you guys. And I don't even know if I'm following you. I do have your app, but I don't follow you. So I'm going to follow you there, guys, quickly. And then Changely Team 2. Okay, guys, if you're enjoying this, make sure to subscribe to the channel because I know I'm bringing you great content. You guys should smash the thumbs up on the video because this video takes a lot of time and energy, as you can see, to put through, let alone editing everything. And with that being said, the Bank of International Settlements calls for blockchain-based sustainable finance solutions. So not only are all these institutions coming in, but the Bank of International, the BIS and the IMF, they're part of this, they're pretty much one and the same thing together. They're all buddy-buddy with one another. They all do their things. This article's from Tikedia. And yeah, guys, I mean, just very, very simple. A green role for distributed ledger technology. Blockchain and sustainability is a green role for distributed ledger technology. And this is insane, guys. With the rubbish ESG thing that they're all talking about, they are going to want to include Bitcoin in this. And they all thought that Bitcoin was a high energy consumption product. Well, guess what? It actually wasn't a high energy consuming product. And I want to show you just exactly why. So this is from Documenting Bitcoin. You guys can see that more than 50% of global Bitcoin mining is powered by renewable energy sources. According to new research, Bloomberg, this would make Bitcoin one of the most sustainable industries in the entire world. Guys, I have to share with you. I thought this was incredible. I'm going to show you another video here. Buying fruit in Costa Rica using Bitcoin. Look at this. Boom. Done. Within seconds, you can buy your fruit with a cell phone using Bitcoin. How absolutely incredible is that, right, guys? Well, look at that. Look at that. Look at that. Boom. Boom. Thank you. So I want to show you guys this video now. This is a local Texas news station reports Bitcoin mining is helping balance the energy grid and keeping electricity prices in check. It's going to have a
mining company raked in record profits reportedly because of this record Texas heat. And they got paid to cut back on energy usage. Interesting. ABC 13 senior digital producer Brittany Wilmore is in our newsroom this morning with how this all worked out. Good morning, Brittany.
Good morning. Yeah, so ERCOT paid a company named Riot $31.7 million to cut back on that energy usage during our heat wave last month. And it's all part of the grid operator's demand response program. So this is how it works. In short, ERCOT will pay entities, or in this case, Bitcoin miners who use a lot of power, to cut back during periods of peak demand, thus easing stress on the grid. Riot says it reduced power use more than 95% during those peak periods, earning the credits and keeping its own costs under control. It all comes as we were asked to conserve multiple times last month. But one energy expert explains it like this. He says ERCOT will call on large loads that have a contract with them to turn off at strategic times.
So a normal conservation is, hey, can you turn up your AC a bit? Can you not run your dryer? Can you try not to use your oven? EEA2 is an ERCOT action. They went and took an action and said, hey, we're going to go and have these loads turn off to make more room on the grid.
So Riot has operations north of Austin that they've also been ramping down for years to kind of help ease this burden on the grid. But it's interesting because ERCOT relies on these miners in other ways by counting on them to use excess power when there's too much supply. That way they can help keep our prices in check. Back to you.
That is absolutely mind-blowingly powerful. So Riot are being paid nearly $32 million to essentially help lower the cost of using energy with Bitcoin. Well, guys, what is that saying to you? Bitcoin can do that. I mean, here in South Africa, literally while I'm recording this video right now, we had what is called load shedding. Some of the collaborators, shout out to all of you, my beautiful friends out there in the crypto space. we have, when I've been doing collaborations with them, I have to arrange it around these power cuts. So even though we have generators and solar panels and that kind of stuff, it still affects us. There's still, like, if I go home, there's no other alternative in terms of power. So we're sitting with anything between 8 to 12 hours without electricity every day. And those that are in spaces where they don't have generators, and I mean, even shopping centers, some shopping centers are not even using the generators because they can't pay or they can't afford the petrol usage for the mall for the amount of load shedding that we're having. So we need Bitcoin in South Africa. If you are South African, shout out to you. Let's get Bitcoin mining locally as well so we can help our load shedding problems in our country. Forget our government because they ain't going to do anything. They're just pocketing the money for themselves. All right, guys. So last little hype article that I want to, little video that I want to share with you is from Natalie Brunel. She's an incredible host. She does Coin Stories podcast, and she's a woman of Bitcoin, and she is one of the few women in the space. I think she's incredible. She's got a lot of information to share.
And I think a nation that lives by Charles, yes, this is why I'm so passionate about Bitcoin. You know, we are addicted to the money printer in this country, and I think a nation that lives by the money printer runs the risk of dying by it as well. I mean, we used to be the world's biggest creditor nation. We made stuff. Now we're the world's biggest debtor nation. We hardly make anything except debt. And so everything is distorted, Charles. I mean, up is down, inflation is good. Our economy is like an airplane flying without an altimeter because we have no price signals based on real interest rates, and we haven't for a long time. Instead, we have a system where insiders print money and they benefit. They create disproportionate access to capital with low interest rates. And that capital goes where? Into stocks of companies that have no real growth. They just use easy government money to finance debt and buy back shares and create synthetic growth in these market bubbles. They buy up real estate and turn the country into renters. I mean, inflation sucks the life out of workers and savers, and it benefits the asset holders. So all of a sudden, we have this ballooning wealth inequality, and politicians who contributed to the problem, who have no clue about basic economics, saying, hey, I'll come fix it by spending and handing out more easy money. I mean, it's like the government cripples you and then hands you a crutch and says, aren't you happy I was here to hand you this crutch, right?
Yeah.
That's why Bitcoin is so great. You can't print more of it. It's programmatically scarce, hard money. And as my friend Preston Pish said very well today, Bitcoin literally feasts on corruption and manipulation. And boy, is the plate full, Charles.
You know.
So as you guys can see here, this was when Bitcoin was at 69,000 and Ethereum was at 4,600. So around the all-time highs that video was from. As you can see here, it's pinned here. But the point is that I'm trying to say to you is that the money printers continue. They continue. And if a recession starts to kick in, guys, make no mistake. They have no other choice but to switch on the money printers again. China's going to do it. Europe is going to do it. All of these countries are just going to start to switch on the money printers once again. So really just very, very, very powerful information here. And I just want to leave you with one or two more articles. First one I want to share with you is, of course, you can see here the current SEC commissioners, Hester Price is a Republican, and Gary Gensler is a Democrat, Mark Ayeda is a Republican, Caroline is a Democrat, and Jamie is a Democrat. So there's three Democrats and two Republicans, and the Republicans are both pro-Bitcoin and don't actually agree with the rest of the other team members here, which is very, very interesting because, I mean, what we can see, Gary Gensler's term expires in 2026. So his mandate is pretty much to just continue to obliterate. Whatever that means, that's okay. You know, he's going to be let go of at some point. The space is going to fight back and point back at him. And one of the last things I want to show you is Gemini Earn users could recover all funds in new DCG remuneration scheme. So DCG suggests a new deal in Genesis bankruptcy offering unsecured credit to 70 to 90% baseline recovery. If approved, it would involve the renegotiation of a $630 million loan between Genesis and DCG. That would be amazing, guys. If Gemini were to agree to provide $100 million to Gemini Earn users under the proposed agreement, as it previously did, there would be little doubt Gemini Earn users would receive more than full recovery. Now, guys, that is amazing, amazing, amazing news because, you know, we've had so many crypto projects and exchanges and platforms absolutely just become obliterated. And this is a good sign for the crypto space. You can see there's the light at the end of the tunnel in the image. And actually, at the end of the day, you guys will know for yourself that Celsius is one of those. I have money still locked in Celsius. Actually, one of my biggest Bitcoin holdings is actually in Celsius. So Bitcoin and Ethereum holdings, unfortunately. So hopefully there will be some sort of recovery back there in that aspect too. In the meantime, guys, the Bitcoin price is not going anywhere, in my personal view, but up right now, especially over the long term. You can see here that on the monthly time frame, we are very, very overbought, and it is starting to pull down. So are we going to get a little bit of a retracement back down? Who knows, guys? I don't know. But what I do want to say to you is that it does not matter whether we go much lower, okay? Even if we hit the target here that I said, it's okay. Just enter into your position. And I know probably not many of us have much dry powder left because we have been in the longest term sitting sideways in capitulation or consolidation on crypto prices. And you guys can see that now. We've been down for a very long time. So since 1 year now, we have literally more than 1 year, we have been trading sideways. So we've been trying to buy through this entire time frame over here. Stack up on your crypto stackings, and that is great. Just keep stacking, guys, because eventually at one point one day we're going to see crazy runs just like that and just like that. So if you guys enjoyed the content, make sure you go ahead down in the pinned in the description below and pinned in the comments below. You will see your BitFlex link where you guys can go ahead and trade Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies with me. I am still in my long position on Bybit. It has come up a little bit, but it is still in the negative. I have still been adding to that position, and I'm building that position to be a very, very, very big position, a couple thousand dollars. I will talk to you guys a little bit about that in a little while and what I did and why I traded that particular way. Much love, beautiful blessings. Make sure to watch this one because this one was even crazier than this one. Let me know what you guys think about the video, what you thought, and if there is anything that you guys would like to know from me, from the channel, let me know down in the comments below. If there's any videos or cryptos you want me to talk about, let me know. I am so excited to do those for you. Much love and beautiful blessings, wonderful souls. See you on the next one.